dreams of.
For me, eSports is really this burgeoning culture of actual sports in that you have young adults competing in a team-oriented fashion. And what we're seeing with eSports right now is that beginning part where it's growing in popularity and people are starting to realize, hey, this is something I can watch. This is something I can be entertained by. And this is something that I can do. I can play League with my friends. And then when I watch the professionals do it, it's really fun because I know what they're doing.
Bubble Force and then go into the fight. They go in for fake and they do commence the crescendo, but they haven't got him down yet. He's going to run away from this one. Will finally get caught out. And Royal Gaming getting caught out completely. They are just dropping like flies.
5-on-5. Each person controls their own character with the idea of destroying the enemy base. So you have to go through towers. Things are shooting at you. But at the end of the day, the objective is to destroy the base as a team.
Picked up the kill on Nidalee, onto Orianna, everyone on CLG is dead!
Shoutcaster is basically a sports broadcaster.
Shoutcasting is, you know, commentating whatever is on the screen, trying to hype it up as much as possible, and deliver a good amount of information as well.
If you don't understand the high-level strategies, we're going to help break those down. And if you just like yelling like we do, then we're going to bring that as well.
Such a complicated game. We have so many different champions, we have so many different skills, we have so many different tactics, but if I didn't teach somebody something about the game during a cast, I don't think I've really done my job.
I kind of feel like I'm on the Sports Center set right now. I mean, and that's not unintentional.
Yeah, that's not an accident.
Players from every corner of the globe will have a chance to compete for an unprecedented $5 million prize pool. The prizing will be distributed throughout the season, culminating in a $2 million global championship tournament.
I'd say that professional gaming really started to take off with the popularity of Brood War in Korea. It's a popular multiplayer online game, and that was really where the professional gaming was born. I mean, it exploded, absolutely exploded. We're talking millions of dollars in revenue, brand name sponsorships, and just overall popularity in the public sector.
With the recent League of Legends World Championship, which was held in the Staples Center, all the seats sold out in 5 minutes. You know, it was a huge event.
Yeah, I mean, if you look at the online viewing numbers, at any given time, there are at least 8 million people watching. And I think there are over 32 million people watching the games overall, just over the course of I think it was a weekend, right?
Yeah.
Over the course of the weekend. Which is astonishing. I mean, people really care about watching professional gaming, and it's just completely taking off. I mean, look, at 5 years ago, you wouldn't see anything near that, but now it's a mainstream event that's selling out major American stadiums, and there are people watching it at home. So I see how it's growing in popularity, and it's almost on the level of American sports.
And just like traditional sports, esports has, you know, its celebrities. It has its heroes. It has its villains. It has the people you love, the people you love to hate. It has the rivalries. It has everything that makes sports so amazingly engaging. And it's just on a virtual battlefield.
So I don't think people realize the kind of strenuous effort that really goes into the pro gaming lifestyle.
The time that you have to put in order to be that good at a video game, it's the same amount of time you have to put in to be good at a physical sport. It's just, this is a mental sport. And there's also physical aspects. I mean, you have to be able to react. Your reaction times have to be right up there just as much as with a baseball player or a football player, because if you don't see that jungler coming out, then you're probably first blood.
I would talk to my friends and they would just be like, well, I play video games 2 hours a day, 3 hours a day, like against all my opponents, I do pretty well. So what could you possibly be doing? And I don't think they realize that in order to be at your peak performance, you have to be playing 8-9 hours a day. I mean, those gamers at the top of the charts, those people that are making money off of gaming, they're living in a team house, they're working together at all times, they're developing chemistry that translates onto the virtual playing field.
You see a lot of these big firms starting to sponsor these pros, and even for League of Legends, there's like an amateur scene, so kind of like a D-League, that's sponsored by Coca-Cola.
can he earn a year as what you called a cyber athlete?
They won't tell you specifically. They sort of hold that up. But six figures, I'd guess, in the couple $100,000 a year. Because remember, they're getting money from the league. They're getting money from the sponsors. They're getting money if they train online and stream it live so that their fans can join. That means they're getting $60 an hour, something like that. Hmm. You know, so there are lots of different ways that they're getting money. They get prize money as well. That can add up to, you know, $200,000, $250,000.
They will be the season three world champions here at the Staples Center.
The prize money they give out in tournaments varies, but for the world finals, I know the top team, I think it was $2 million for the world champions. And a lot of these players earn money through sponsorships as well. So the top players are earning six figures. This isn't a joke. This is real.
There's a stigma more towards playing the game itself. Like, you don't usually go up to somebody and say, hey, I play World of Warcraft. Hey, I play League of Legends, because of the negative stereotypes they might think of. But culture is becoming more popular, like the advent of superhero movies and people wearing, like, superhero shirts and stuff like that. So the face of what a typical nerd or gamer is has been evolving and changing.
There's just been a lot of moments of just extreme triumph, moments of crippling defeat, moments of intense pressure, and then just moments where legends are made. And that's just what really makes esports just so special to me. And,
you know,
where I really found my love.
I'd even argue that esports are even more of a sport than some real sports. I mean, take NASCAR, for instance.
When I started watching League of Legends and the Season 2 World Finals, my favorite team, back then they were called Counter Logic Gaming. They were in... it was the quarterfinals against World Elite, which is like this powerhouse Chinese team. The game score was tied 2-2 in a best of five. And the last game was a 50-minute game, which the average game is like 20 to 30 minutes. 50 minutes at that time was unheard of. I was on the edge of my seat the entire game. And when they won, I never thought I'd cheer so loudly watching a video game.
Do you think it's a fad?
I don't think it's a fad at all.
Do you think it's a sport?
I do think it's a sport. I do think it's a sport because, and I've had some arguments with dear friends about this over the last couple of days. It requires agility. It requires the ability to think through situations, right? There's strategy. Those 1% guys are really, really good at something. And I think they're good at a sport. And then you have the framing, a league, mm-hmm. You know, prize money. Yeah, I mean, what's your definition of a sport? And I think it's a sport.